I can't believe it. I just don't believe it. We're never gonna get a hold of that stupid lamp. Just forget it. Look at this. Look at this. I'm so ticked off that I'm molting.
There's absolutely nothing wrong with having an imaginary friend. In fact, I still have an imaginary friend. I call him Gilbert.
That's my name. That's my name. Why wouldn't you call me Gilbert? That's my name. My name's Gilbert.
And even though Gilbert is imaginary, he's always there if I need someone to talk to or a shoulder to cry on.
I told you 1,000 times, I'm not imaginary. I'm real. You see me? I'm real. Look, you want identification? Here, here, anything you want. You want a driver's license? You want ID? You want a birth certificate?
Hey, maybe we could say hello to Gilbert right now. Oh, Gilbert.
I'm here. I'm right here. I'm right in front of you.
If you could only hear what he's saying to me right now. He's such a joker.
Okay, that's it. I'm out of here because you're a nutcase.
Always getting attention. But some of you still don't know quack about.
Aflac!
So I'll serve it up. If you get sick or hurt, Aflac pays you cash fast to help pay for things major medical insurance doesn't, like rent, car payments, and groceries.
Aflac!
Get up, it's chicken.
Oh, wait a minute, Jafar. What if you were the chump husband?
What?
Okay, you marry the princess, all right? And you become the Sultan.
Marry the shrew.
I become the Sultan?
The idea has merit.
Yes, merit, yes! And then we drop Papa-in-law and the little woman off a cliff. Yeah! Curse splat!
I love the way your foul little mind works.
Class, please welcome our graduation speaker, President Abraham Lincoln.
Hiya, schmucks! 67 years ago, I was broke, just like you. But now I'm the president, and I'm so fucking rich, I can have all the licorice I want.
I don't think that's the real President Lincoln.
I am making the fastest chicken nuggets in the entire planet. The fastest...
People can't believe how fast new microwave hot bites are.
Hot bites! Look at them! Look how tasty and delicious, and in only 2 minutes, I mean...
6 nuggets with sauce in 2 minutes. All tender, juicy breast meat.
You know, with these chicken nuggets, I never have to leave the house. I think I never will leave the house. You know, I think I might lock myself in the house all day.
New microwave hot bites from Banquet.
Wait a second, this isn't my house! I'm in someone else's house! Get me out of here!
You got a problem, Pinky?
Jerk.
Boy, Jafar's gonna be happy to see you.
Excellent work, Iago.
Ah, go on.
No, really, on a scale of 1 to 10, you are an 11.
Oh, Jafar, you're too kind. I'm embarrassed. I'm blushing.
Yes, special guest weather appearance. Gilbert's making his way to the stage. Yeah. Have you ever done the weather before?
All the time.
Oh, well then, you got this.
Yes.
You're pro at this. So go ahead and read off some of the temperatures around the area. These are the temps, not wind chills, but temperatures.
Okay. There's, there's gales per, I think that's -6 degrees.
Face this way.
Oh, I'm
so it looks
sorry.
Like you're looking at the, yes. There you go. See, okay. It's kind of backwards.
Okay. That's, and in Macomb, that's like, -degrees, and Bloomington, -2 degrees, Peoria, -3. You could be in Peru, where it's -6.
So that when you factor in
so
the wind,
be happy if you're not living in Peru.
This is what it's actually feeling like with the wind chills. So even worse than the temperatures you just read off. Sometimes we're feeling like 25
that
below.
I don't understand.
See, you don't
understand when they'll say, well, tomorrow's 50 degrees, but it'll feel like zero. And it's like, so shouldn't that be
at this
zero
point,
degrees?
At this point, we would kill for some 50-degree weather at this point.
Yes, yeah, well, that's in Peoria. Yeah, yeah, in Peoria, it's like, it's 5 degrees. Let's go to the beach.
Pretty much at this point, yeah. So yes. we're going to keep all those wind chill
Let's
alerts
have
going
a picnic.
Into the afternoon. Yeah, no kidding.
We'll
I mean,
dig out from the snow and
check out the 7-day forecast next week. Those are the highs next Wednesday and Thursday.
Okay, there's Friday. That's
look
one
at that. Here, I'll move you a little bit. So here's the next Wednesday and Thursday. Yeah.
I see. Okay, Friday. Oh, now it's good.
Your update is next.
Illinois. What the hell?
Here, have lots of.
Stop it! Leave him alone!
Yeah, I understand. Wait, somebody won't wait. Yeah, oh, come right in. Don't let the fact that my door's closed dissuade you in any way from entering my office.
Sir, we're at the Beverly Hills Police Department. Are you Mr. Sidney Bernstein?
Yes, lucky guess.
Well, sir, you have 25 unpaid parking tickets. We have a warrant for your arrest.
25? What 25?
You have 25 unpaid parking tickets, sir.
I pay my tickets. I pay all my tickets.
Sir, do you own a black Mercedes-Benz license plate number CRL507?
507? That's my wife's car. That's not my car. That's
she
my
has 25 unpaid parking tickets.
It's under my name, but it's my wife's car. No. Bitch!
Your tickets have not been paid. That means you're liable. Can you cuff Mr. Bernstein, please?
Cuff me! There are people out there with chainsaws. You're cuffing me.
Well, sir, you have 25 unpaid parking tickets, and it's your car, so we have to take you in.
Wait a second. I've got an idea. Is there something that I have in this office that I could hand to you and that would make you kind of forget that you're holding those little pink tickets there?
What are you trying to say, sir?
Like you'd be holding something in that hand. And this hand, you'd forget about. This hand, you'd be concentrating on. That hand, you'd go, what did I have there? I don't even remember.
Oh, you mean like if I had, $200 in this hand?
Ouch! Let go of my arm! $200! Ouch! Please, I'm robbing you. That's what I'm doing. Here's one, here's two. They're real crisp.
Well, now that you think about it, Mr. Bernstein.
Yes?
Yeah, I'm gonna have to use your computer because I have to wipe all evidence of this transaction out, you know.
No problem. No problem at all.
Thank you, Sidney, so much.
Oh, certainly.
Thank you
certainly.
Very much.
Yes.
Also, Sidney, one other thing.
Yes,
I'm quite sure a man in your position understands that my contact down at headquarters wouldn't want his name to be known.
Don't I know it?
Right.
Don't I know it?
Could you excuse me for a second while I...
Uh-huh. Oh, you're going to... Yes, it's secret. It's like a James Bond thing.
Exactly.
Sure. Yes.
Thank you.
No problem. Hey, no problem at all. Anything you want to use.
Finally! This is terrific! I've got sand in places I didn't even know I had.
Spare me your prattling, Iago! Are we out yet?
Are we out yet? Are we out yet? Yes, we're out! No thanks to you! Part from me! You'll be stuck down there forever!
You will now release me,
so that I may have my revenge.
Yeah, when I'm good and ready.
Do as I say, you worthless pipsqueak!
You know something? You're nothing without me.
What?
Who comes up with all the good ideas? Me! Who does all the work? Me!
If it weren't for me, you'd still be in a cage at the bazaar, squawking, Polly wants a cracker!
That's it! I've had it! I hate to be dramatic, but it's time for me to fly the coop! Terrific! Fine! I'm drawing the line before I wind up in a parrot suit! I was a fool to let you run the show!
What?
I'm cutting you loose, pal! Look out below! I'm in the dirt sheet! Say la vie! Hope all goes well! Looking out for me!
Acrobats!
just a juicy golden goose ready for plucking. And I'm the one holding the tweezers. I'll be running this town inside a week. What's your problem, Liverlip? You don't think I can do it? Okay, I'm little. Been playing second fiddle and I don't get no respect. I turn the other cheek, but this busted beak is the only thanks that I get. I never found a friend that I can trust. They promise caviar and leave me eating dust. That's some reward for loyalty from here on in. I'm looking out for me.
From us again, and your squinny buddy will be dinner for the jackals!
No problem.
Hey, Pea Brain, what are you doing here?
What am I doing here? What are you doing here? I belong here. You belong in Cold River. This is Mortville. What are you doing here? You're not here. That's it. That's the only answer. You're not here. Ha ha ha! You're not here. I'm imagining you. You're a figment of my imagination.
Well, if I was a figment of your imagination, could I do this?
Oh! Whoa! Oh, did something crawl in here and die? Whoa! You disgusting kid! You disgusting, flatulating kid! Whoa, I just had a new paint job, too. Oh, this is horrible. Huh, great. What grade are you in?
Third.
Third? That means you're here for another 4 years. This is a mistake. This is a big mistake, because you are a genius. You are so intelligent. Anyone who can break wind like that has to have a mind. So, I'm going to pass you on to the sixth grade, and in 1 year, you're going to be in another school.
But my dad says third grade is the foundation of my education.
Oh, your dad says that. Your dad is a moron! He's a moron! You know what a moron is? That's what your dad is! Anyway, you don't belong here. You belong in the sixth grade. That's where you are, because you're a genius, kid. A genius.
Our next roaster is Gilbert Gottfried. Now, Gilbert is famous not so much for his comedy, but for pissing off more Asian people than Hiroshima. Please welcome that scary thing under your bed from when you were a kid, Gilbert Gottfried!
Jane Lynch! Ladies and gentlemen, I hope you can hear the sound of my voice. This microphone is covered by the thick layer of pubic hairs that shot from between Jane's teeth. During each commercial break, the producers wipe away the pelt of saliva-coated pubes that accumulate upon the mic. And each time Jane returns to the stage, she once again sprays a carpet of short, curly hairs all over the microphone and the front row of the nauseated audience members. So forgive me if my voice is, shall we say, muffled. Carrie Fisher, thank you for visiting us from the past. When Comedy Central looked at this dais, they said, we just don't have enough washed up, repugnant, drug addicted menopausal has-beens. Get me Carrie Fisher. Because if there's anything we're certain of, it's that Carrie Fisher is available. R2-D2 has gotten more works in Star Wars than Carrie Fisher.
And he has his period.
Tonight isn't about Carrie Fisher or Jeff Ross or any of the other disease-ridden transients who were forced from their shanties and refrigerator box dwellings to be here.
Hello, tech desk.
Ahem, yes, it looks like you're using Office XP.
What? Who is this?
Don't you miss having a talking paperclip to guide you through common tasks?
No!
Ow!
So, did they upgrade your computer to Office XP?
No, not yet.
And I hope they never do!
Huh?
I didn't say that.
Hey, nice hat.
Thanks!
Hey, I've got that Office XP now.
Oh, yeah? What do you think?
Because I hate it.
Say what? Hey, when did you get glasses? Oh, hold still. Hold very still.
Ouch.
I hear we're upgrading to that new Office XP.
Yes, I'm setting you up next.
Too bad Office XP stinks.
But I hear Office XP stinks.
Really? Who says that?
This plant does.
Listen, I'm a tech guy. I make a lot more than this plant. Office XP is a great upgrade, and it doesn't have that paperclip.
But I kind of like that paperclip.
But I kind of like that... No, I don't. I hate that thing. Hey, plant, you're fired.
Ow!
They've come for our brains! Get away!
Is it me or just my pretty face? Maybe it's my Daisy Fresh scent.
You must be new here.
And you must be Captain Obvious. My name is Rick, Rick Platypus, but you can call me Rick Platypus.
Okay. Anyway, sorry about the way my friends reacted to you. They can be a little dramatic sometimes.
Don't sweat it, Pally. I'd react the same way to a brain-sucking alien.
Hiya, Toots! Beetle's my name, and Razzmatazz is my game. How do you do? How you feeling? Everything okay?
I'm not your Toots. Where did you come from?
Where? Up there. I'm a connoisseur of sweet nectars, a designer of rare threads, and a judge of beautiful women. And you are beautiful, Miss,
Thumbelina, and I'm going home.
What's your hurry, Toots? Relax, take a load off.
Oh, I wish you wouldn't do that.
Perhaps you'd prefer this.
Oh, Mr. Beetle! I don't even know you! Would you stop?
Stop! How can I stop? I'm crazy about you, Toots. You're gorgeous. Ooh, you're exciting. Ooh, delicious.
I am.
And I love the sound of your voice.
My voice?
Don't talk. Sing. Sing to me.
I have an idea. Can you fly me up there?
Why should I, Toots?
Well, from the treetops, I could see my house.
Then I know if I'm traveling in the right direction to get home.
Gee, I don't know. That would be a big, big, oh, very big favor.
I'll sing for you.
No, you'll sing at the Beetle Ball and dance.
Woo!
We are gonna be the talk of the town, Toots!
Suffering from is called obsessive compulsive behavior.
Throw the ball.
Whenever you want the ball, I want you to think about something else.
Just don't say anything more. Just throw the ball.
Can
just,
you relax please, your mind?
Please. This is the way it works. You're the person. Right. You throw the ball.
Okay,
I'm the dog.
All right,
I get
let's...
it. Simple as that.
Look at you going.
I swear. Pee on your car. Please.
It's very
please,
irritating,
please,
this ball thing.
Please throw the ball. Shut up and throw the ball. Am I alone here? Am I all by myself? Am I in another universe?
Throw the damn ball.
He threw the ball! Oh, he threw the ball! He threw the onion! Come on! I love you!
You can't save them all, Hasselhoff!
If I stay quiet one more second, I'd need a colossal barf bag!
Ha! Huh, you funny little big head man!
Mr. Mixia's Spitlick at your service.
Mr. Mizzy Blizzy?
Don't bother. Look at the funny Mr. Clowny!
Clowns? I hate clowns!
And I'm sure they hate you too, kid! Nuke 'em!